Welcome back guys to another quick tutorial on how to cut in yourself. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, subscribe, click on the bell icon so you get notified whenever I post a new video. Let's get it guys. So the basics, first thing you're going to want to do is tap on the plus icon, then create a canvas size. You can use the default canvas size or you can create a larger canvas size by tapping on the new canvas here and editing your size. But I already have my size set down here, so I usually use 4000 by 4000 pixels. I'm going to tap on that, then tap on the range tool here, add, then import a photo, insert a photo here. I'm going to use this picture. I'm going to be drawing her. I'm going to resize, scale this up just so it fits perfectly. Then I'm going to tap on the range tool again, go into canvas and resize this like this. Yeah, so after doing this I'll reduce my photo opacity, then create a layer above my photo layer, then with technical pen I'll set my streamline to 50%, then start out with the outlining. Whenever I'm drawing outlines, I always start out with the outer part of the picture first, using a thicker brush size. Next, I'm drawing the inner details of the picture with a smaller brush size. Alright, so here is something that actually gives people a lot of issues. I don't know why, but while I'm drawing the inner part of the hair, the details of the hair, I don't really stress to draw every single hairline. I just draw the most obvious curves on the hair. So that's what I'm doing here right now. Next thing I'm going to be drawing are our eyebrows. I know our eyebrows are kind of brown, or should I say blonde, but I usually draw my outline using black. I use black throughout my outlines. So after drawing this outline, the other details will be added while I'm painting this artwork. So the way I draw my eyebrows, I just sketch out the eyebrow lines from the bottom to the top. I'm just sketching it down from the bottom to the top, and merging them together, making the end of the eyebrows thicker. Alright, so let's finish up this outline. So this first part of the outline are just really easy parts you can just watch and pick out really quick. Alright, so for our lips right now, I'm not really comfortable with the way it was looking, I don't know. So I'm just gonna tweak it up a little bit. Let's see if it is better. Alright, so the lips look great already. I'm just adding some little details to the art. So right now I'm going to add in some extra detail to the lip and also this black line to under the chin. I just feel like adding that. That's it, it's not about art, you're adding stuff. It's a cartoon, right? Adding stuff and make it look better. Okay, now we're done with the outline. So next step now is painting. So while I paint, I usually always add up a reference and I do not use the Procreate reference to always slide up my gallery on the corner and add up my reference. Next, I use select to tap on automatic, then just tap around the corners of the picture. That's the background of the picture. If I tap on it on any particular background of the picture and it automatically fills into the wrong part, I hold into it and slide down my threshold. Now I'm going to go into freehand and invert my selection. Create a new layer underneath the outline layer. Select a nice skin color because I don't really pick out my skin tone from the original picture. I usually formulate my skin color. So now she's light skin, I'm just going to keep trying out colors to see which one fits better. Yeah, now I got my skin tone selected already. If you're having a hard time with picking up the skin tone, you can pick up the skin tone from the original picture and edit it a little bit just so it looks alright. At least that might ease the stress. So next thing I'm going to do is go into my layers, my outline layer to be precise, tap on reference and start making my base colors. So now I drop in the ink and I just fuse up everywhere. I'm going to drop in the ink again and slide down my pencil to reduce the threshold. So I'm just doing the base colors of the art right now. I don't know if I mentioned earlier, but I prefer making my base colors first before the shadings. Some artists do shade first before doing their base colors. But I already do my base colors first because it gives me this feeling of I'm seeing how my art is going, so I know what's coming next. Yeah, now it's time to make the hair. I always make hair on a different layer above the painting layer. That's right underneath the outline. So I'm going to turn off my referencing and start filling up my hair manually. So the next step into this art is the shading. So I'm creating a new layer. Before we head right to the shading, I'm gonna make some red blushes on her face, because she actually has some red blushes on her face. So I'm gonna turn in my layer to multiply, and then use my soft airbrush and just spray out these red edges. My first layer of shading, I'm going to create a new layer above the painting layer, select my skin tone, take it down a little bit and slide this down a little into red. So then I'm going to use my technical pen and start out my shadings. I'm just testing out the shading color till I find out what is suitable for me. Alright, so I'm cool with this color right now. So what I'm going to do next is turn off my painting layer, then just trace out the dark areas of the picture. So I'm just shading out these dark areas right now, showing you guys the areas that are dark. Now we know the dark areas, we're just going to want to smoothen out these shadings. I'm following the shading on the picture, I'm actually trying to make it smooth. And if you notice, I'm reducing my brush size, because that's actually a new way I do my shading. I actually reduce my brush size so I can easily do these shadings and make it look neat. Okay, so now I'm done with the vector shade. I usually use my eraser to smoothen off the shading. So you can see around the corner of the nose there, this shading isn't that thick. It's actually kind of lighter. So I usually use the soft airbrush to just soften this shading a little bit by slightly fading it off on the parts that look softer on the original picture. That's what I'm doing. Like I said earlier, I'm using a pressure brush, which makes the work easier. If you're not using a pressure brush, you have to reduce your opacity downwards and keep erasing that particular spot till it fades to the extent you want it to. Sorry, there are a lot of children in my surroundings, so please bear with me. We're going to be hearing a lot of kid sounds. So now the next layer of shading, I'm going to create a new layer. Then using my previous color, I'm going to slide it down and take it down a little into red. Alright, so now I'm just testing out my color, trying to find a suitable color which I'm going to use for the next dark shade layer. So I think I'm actually okay with this. I'm going to work with this. So now we turn off both the previous shading layers and the base color layer. So now I'm going to trace out the darker shade. So now I'm tracing out the areas that are darker than the previous shading. Done with the next shading layer. So next I'm going to do now is use this eraser and fade out the parts which are lighter in the picture, just like we did in the previous shade. So for this picture, I'm going to create another dark layer. Normally I usually use just two dark layers, but for this picture I'm going to use three dark layers, because there are some extra darker areas in this picture which I want to make look darker. For my highlights, I'm creating a layer above my other layers, picking up my skin tone and making it lighter. So what I'm doing here is just using my technical pen to shade around the areas of the picture which seems like light is coming into those areas. Then use the soft airbrush as an eraser to just blend in these shadings. For our forehead, I'm just going to use the soft brush to fade in the light source into our forehead. So next thing I'm going to do now is adding the bounce light effect. I'm making my color lighter, creating a new layer. Then I'm just going to draw out some lines using my technical pen. Draw out some lines on the edges of the picture, just to make it look like the light, they see sharp lights coming into the picture. This actually makes my work stand out. So next up, her eyes. I'm not going to leave her eyes white like this, because nobody has this kind of eyes. So I'm going to use blue, create a layer above the painting layer, and just fill up the whole white areas of the eyes, because there's nobody else that actually has this kind of pure white eyes. That's actually artificial. So I'm just gonna make the eyes look a little bit realistic, fill it up, then use my soft airbrush as an eraser to fade out the eyes. So next up, I'm simply drawing the details of her iris. So I'm just gonna use a lighter color to shade into the iris with my technical pen, then use my soft airbrush as an eraser to fade out this shading. Now I'm going to a higher layer, making my color lighter again, just adding more details to the iris. So lastly, I'm going to use the technical pen on a new layer that's above the outline layer, then use white to just making this light effect nice. Alright, so now time for our eyebrows. Like I said earlier in the video, I'm going to address her eyebrows while I'm doing the painting. So now I'm just going to alpha lock the outline layer by swiping my two fingers and then going to my soft airbrush. So now whatever shading I do on the outline layer, it's not going to go outside the outline layer. I'm just going to use this blonde color, which is brown, to just spray around the eyes firstly. Then I'm going to use my technical pen, reduce the opacity down, make my brown darker and start drawing the lines of the eyebrows. Next, I'm going to be doing the light shade of the lips. So I'm going back to my initial highlight layer, picking up the lip color and making it lighter using my technical pen. I'm just going to trace out the shading of the lip right now. With all that being done, it's time for the hair. Why do I paint my hair on a different layer? So here's why. I usually make my hair alpha lock and I'm going to use my soft airbrush so I can just focus on the hair. Whatever shading I'm doing is not going to go outside the hair. So I'm just going to use a darker color right now and just spray around the dark regions of the hair right now. So with my hair layer on a different layer, I can try to select the hair layer itself and go into new layers and make my shadings without it going outside the hair layer. So now I'm creating a new layer for the dark shade of the hair. I'm using a darker brown right now with a technical pen, reducing the opacity down. So I'm just going to sketch out the details of the hair. I'm just using the technical pen to sketch out the hair details, looking at the reference, just sketching it out randomly on the dark areas of the hair.
This hair has a lot of color variations.
Yeah, exactly. This hair has a lot of color variations, so that's why I'm using different dark colors to shade out the hair. And this area, I'm just trying to fill up the dark areas of the hair right now. So like I said while I was doing my outline, I do not draw out the details of the hair on the outline. I create a layer while I'm doing my painting and shading, then use my technical pen, reduce my opacity down and just draw out nearly every detail of the hair. Now I'm done with this, I'm creating a new layer above the previous shading layer for the highlights of the hair. I'm picking up the hair layer, the hair color now, I'm making this lighter. With the same technical pen and opacity down, I'm just going to start sketching out the outlines, the shadings of the hair. Where I can see light on here, I'm just sketching it out, following what I'm seeing on the reference. So for the lighter parts of the hair, I just shade continuously, like shade backwards, like down the hair, making it look lighter. So to make it a brighter shade, continue shading on a particular spot to make it brighter. So finally, I'm going to shade our shirt. So I'm going to go into my shading layer, my first layer of shading, and just use a bluish color. I'm going to use a bluish color because I feel like using a cool tone on our shirt. I'm going to use a cool color, use my technical pen and just trace out the shading from the picture. So now with all that being done, I'm going to try to edit a background for this picture. This actually gives me a lot of stress. Whoa, so after endless hours of trying to pick up a background, I finally came up with this. It doesn't look that good actually. Alright, so this is the end of this tutorial video. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to leave a thumbs up and subscribe if you are new to my channel. If you are a viewer who haven't subscribed yet, subscribe and join the family, guys. Peace out.